Hi everybody, I am Maria Salatino. I am research scientist at Stanford University and CAIPAC. My work is develop instrumentation for cosmic microwave background telescope. I study at Sapienza University of Rome in Italy. I did there my bachelor, master thesis and 4-year postdoc in the research group of Professor Paolo De Bernardis. And later on, I decided to leave Italy. First, I work at Chalmers University of Technology in Sweden, then Princeton University, 3-year postdoc, 1 year in Paris, Astroparticle Cosmology Lab, and since September last year, I am at Stanford University. When I was a kid, I remember I used to look at the moon. Everything changed when I was 9 years old. One day, I skipped school, and I went in a bookstore with my mother, and randomly I found a book about astronomy, about solar system. So I asked my mother to buy that book, and that was my first book in astronomy. I started working on this project because I think it's exciting and I want to contribute on this new experiment. There are two things that I love in my work. I don't like to work in the office. I like to have dirty hands. That's why I like working clean room and on the site of the telescope. And my dream is to work on the South Pole and maybe spend 1 year at the South Pole as a winter rover. And so I'm working on simulating systematic effect coming from an optical element called halfway plate. So SO, the small aperture telescope, will have a rotating birefringent crystal. And we know that this is an essential component to measure an incoming polarized signal that we expect from a cosmic microwave background, BMOD. But also, it came with a lot of systematic effect that we really need to carefully model in order to understand the impact of the systematic effect in the final result. When you think about a rotating halfway plate, for example, the emission from the halfway plate or emission from lenses that is reflected from the halfway plate can easily create a 2F signal and a 4F signal. And so this means that in your target bandwidth, you have not only the cosmological signal, but also a spurious signal from instrument that you need to remove. That's why it's very important to know very well the physics behind the optical element that you are using to carefully model, but also and to carefully model the instrumental emission and to subtract it from the final data. But also you need to know very well the physics to make the choice in terms of observing strategy or instrument design that prevent the systematics to be too high to a level that you don't have an easy control of them. And in the future, I'm looking for to implement machine learning algorithm in SO because we were going to have a lot of data from the detector array, thousands of plots, and machine learning is an appealing strategy to quickly look at thousands of plots in a very efficient way rather than using visual inspection of thousands of plots. When it will be done, I will be excited about having the possibility of playing with such a cutting-edge telescope that for the first time will have put together a great research groups, and that it will have changed the way in which CMB telescope, CMB research group works. So it will, like, the CMB group will make a new step in the style of work, like from like small group to bigger group. And this is already changing the way in which the instrument is designed because people are putting expertise together in order to make a big step. So I am excited from the technological output of all of this. Like, we are pushing technology, we are creating things that don't exist right now. And for me, it's the most exciting part. What I can say to people interested in getting this path is the first Italian astronaut, Samantha Cristoforetti, always says, If you have to make a choice, always pick up the most difficult path. And I totally agree. Never pick up the easy path, but always work on the hardest road, because this will bring you far away where you want to be.